Hey guys, so today I want to check out my Galaxy S3 here with Android 4.1 Jelly Bean versus the new Android 4.3 Jelly Bean stock version of Android that you can now get on the Galaxy S4, at least if you do have the GTANA 505 edition of the Galaxy S4. So the thing here with my Galaxy S3 here is that I'm using the 4G variant of the Galaxy S3 over here. Now that does mean is that I can't download the new leaked Android 4.2.2 because it doesn't work on the GTANA 305N to flash. But if you want to check it out, of course you can use download it and check it out like that. The good thing though was that I can now install the Google edition on my Galaxy S4, and you can do that as well with Android 4.3 also on your HTC One if you have one of those. But if you do have the GTANA 505, the Snapdragon variant of the S4, you can do that. But if you do have the octa-core variant of the S4, you can't. So what is making these devices a little bit different? Well, first of all, on the right side here, of course, with my S3, we do have Samsung's own TouchWiz, which brings Samsung's own apps, their own kind of UI look and feel here with amazing ton of toggles here, which is one of my favorite features here with Samsung. But not just that, but it brings a kind of like another look and feel to it in terms of stock Android. I kind of think both looks very, very good over here. They do have a different place for where you launch the apps here, where you have all your apps and widgets. But overall, I think both looks very, very modern here in terms of its UI. You both have a search, Google search here on the first page. The cool thing though with the stock Android is that when you change page, the search stays up there in the top. It doesn't move around. While of course I have a search widget over here on my TouchWiz. When I change page, it's moving around a little bit, not super annoying, but it's of course very, very good to always have it on top there with Google Now over here. So what is 2 plus 2? What is 2 plus 2?
Google, use an internet search engine, particularly Google.com.
What? What is 2 plus 2?
The answer is 4.
There we go. Set alarm at 8 p.m.
Setting alarm.
And then you can quickly, of course, disable it. It brings a lot of same similarities that you would get in Samsung's own S-Voice that you get here, of course, with TouchWiz. But of course, you also can access Google Now over here. What's up? What is 2 plus 2 minus 8? As you can see, works kind of the same there with Google Now. But here, you do get, of course, some extra things, some TouchWiz features like S-Voice. They kind of do the same thing as Google Now. So let's check it out. And it's kind of like Samsung's Siri competitor, which is Apple's voice assistant. And, of course, you can... What is 2 plus 2? It could be a little bit slow. It's definitely slower than Siri.
Here is the answer to your question.
What? What was that? That was random. Wow. What is the method? What? That's random. Set alarm at 5 p.m.
Alarm.
So you can see there, I was able to set an alarm, but I couldn't cancel the alarm immediately. I had to jump into the app, which kind of sucks. Cancel.
Okay, I saved you.
Remove alarm.
Should I delete this alarm?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, I deleted it.
So it's a little bit a slow guy, especially versus Siri, but it works. It works definitely. If we take a look here also, I mean, of course, on both of these home screens, you can have whatever apps you want, whatever kind of widgets also you want. If take a look here, when we drag down here, I actually do believe TouchWiz is a little bit better. Because first in TouchWiz you can see all your notifications, but then you have a quick place here with all of your toggles, so you can quickly enable and disable GPS, Wi-Fi, sound, Bluetooth, screen rotation, and you have screen brightness here as well. Pretty quick access to, and it also definitely in the latest version of Android and 4.2. That's coming out now for the S3, you do get even more toggles, and of course the S4 with TouchWiz has even more toggles with AirView and AirGestures and stuff, which is nice. It's very, very nice, and also quick access here to the full settings, which looks a little bit old here, but you should update that. Where over here we have the tap on a button, or you can use two fingers to go there instantly. But you only get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 versus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Over here you do get 10, and of course in future updates and 11 with this one. So you get way more over here, and I actually do use toggles a lot. I think they're useful, and I also do enjoy that you don't have to tap on a button or use two fingers, just one little swipe here and see what you want to enable and disable, and especially brightness slider, that you have a slider, you get that when you tap on that. Maybe not super horrible, it's not super horrible, but I definitely do enjoy this a little bit more here. If you take a look here also, I can also of course take a look at separate apps if you would like in future videos. One thing that's new with Android 4.2 and 4.3 of course is that on the lock screen we can have widgets. So when we go to the page here, page on the lock screen, we have a widget, and we can quickly launch an app, in this case the camera, and then we can also add even more here on the side. So if you want to have quick access to Google Plus posts, messaging or something, on the lock screen you can instantly enable that. And then of course you can see here that you don't have any shortcuts down at the bottom, but I do think that you may be able to install that. Here of course you don't have any lock screens in Android 4.1, but I do believe it's going to come in 4.2. But you do have access to 5 different apps, which is quite nice. And then also, as I said, I'm probably going to take a look at, in separate videos, other things like the browser. Now, of course, with the stock version of Android here, most apps that you do get is Google's own, and many of them is apps that you can download on the S3 from the Play Store. Apps like Google Chrome, Google's own Play Music, which is kind of like their Spotify competitor. One thing that I do enjoy here, of course, with the Samsung's own internet browser, is that they have a reader function. So it's the same as with Apple. So if you are on an article and you just want to see the text or maybe the pictures, you can just tap on a button usually, and it will bring you up the clean interface. And HTC has a similar function called text reflow, which is reflows text when you zoom in, so you don't have to think too much about that. You don't kind of get that, from what I've seen at least, in the Google Chrome browser. But then of course the Google Chrome browser has some other nice additions that I might be taking a look at in another video. And then also what I want to say here, of course, with Android 4.3 here on the S4, it's extremely stable. It's extremely stable, has this kind of blue theme to it. And if we bring up the settings here also, you can see that it kind of looks way better here, at least when we are in the settings area. TouchWiz looks very outdated compared to the stock version of Android 4.3 here. I mean, just look at the buttons. It just looks like they need to tweak that a little bit. I mean, wow. It just looks a little bit horrible. But it's not super bad. It's not super bad like that movie. 4.1.2 Jelly Bean. I'm not sure when 4.2 though is gonna come for the 4G edition of the Galaxy S3. I mean, there are a ton of variants out of the Galaxy S3. And as I said in future videos, I can compare these devices more if you tell me specific things that you want to see. And I'm sure if I did show you this, but if you go down here to Android version, you can see over there that it is Android 4.3, still being called Jelly Bean. People are speculating that it was going to be called Key Lime Pie, but that is not the case. But yeah, just a quick overall look here. If we're gonna go to the bottom of this, you could kind of do the same thing on both devices here, but of course, with Android, you can tweak the whole UI, use different launchers and experiment with that. But if you really just want to have the core version here of the Google Edition, especially if you have the S4, the G10 and 505, you can definitely install it and you won't have TouchWiz no more. But as I said, I really, really do enjoy this toggles area here and the brightness slider. In TouchWiz, I think that's my favorite feature actually with TouchWiz. Quickly a look. Have a good day.